I love ultra portable computers. No fans, typically really long battery life, you know, really light portable computers. As most of you know, my main computer is an M4 iPad Pro. That's where I do a lot of my work from. And when Apple offered to send me the new M4 MacBook Air, well, I jumped at the opportunity to review it. This video is sponsored by BitRix24. I start off my day, well, in my office. As always, a diet Dr. Pepper in hand, or my personal favorite, a Dr. Pepper Zero Sugar with cream soda, but those can be hard to find. For the past couple of days, I have been working exclusively from the MacBook Air. That means I put the iPad away. The MacBook Air that I have here is the 15-inch sky blue version. It has the M4 chip with the 10-core CPU and 10-core GPU options, 16 gigs of RAM, 512 gigabytes of storage, and it's about a $1,400 computer. I recently combined my studio and office into one room. Previously, my office was in this nook at the end of our hallway. I found this to be a really distracting place to work when other people were home, and it was causing me not to want to use my desk setup a lot of the time. With this new combined setup, I'm able to close the door and block out all distractions. Whether I'm dealing with email or filming a video, I can just silo myself off to my workspace when other people are home. Now, one thing I did try was using two studio displays at this setup. The new M4 MacBook Air supports up to two external displays plus the lid of the laptop open. This setup lasted a few hours for me. I was constantly distracting myself with the other display. But for those that can use this, it's here now if you want it. After figuring out what mechanical keyboard I'm going to use for the day, I sit down to tackle my administration work. This is the stuff I like doing the least, so if I don't do it first thing in the morning, it will never get done. For this, I am currently using Apple's first-party apps, Mail, Reminders, and Calendar. I just did a big video about my reminder setup. I will link to that and everything else in the description below. I recently wrote an Apple script that launches all of my basic apps, but it does it in the proper spaces. I use Keyboard Maestro to run this Apple script, and it's triggered with the keyboard shortcut Hyperkey 0. This launches admin apps in space 1, work and research apps in space 2, then social and communication apps in space 3. This is a great way to get everything up and running quickly. When starting with my day, I always go over my task list and calendar first. I can't tell you how many times I've had a meeting booked for a day and just forgot about it going into it. This way, I have a heads up of everything that's going on. Then I spend some time tackling my email. I have no neat trick or fancy app to help with this, unfortunately. I've tried them all, but really all that works for me is just sitting down and tackling each email one by one. I really hate email. After going through my admin work, I like to take a little bit of time to go through technology news videos and my read it later backlog. This workflow is very similar to what I do on the iPad. I use the service Feedbin to gather my RSS feeds, newsletters, and YouTube subscriptions. Then I use the app Lear as the front end for this. Raindrop.io is back to being my read it later and bookmarking app. I liked GoodLinks, but I really needed something that was more bookmark focused. Raindrop.io has an excellent Safari extension that allows you to save any link. Plus, it allows you to add it to a collection, tag it, add a note. But my personal favorite feature is add a highlight. This takes any text that you've highlighted in an article and will turn this into a snippet in Raindrop.io. This video is sponsored by BitRix24. BitRix24 is a platform to manage all of your tasks and projects, collaborate with your team, no matter where you are. BitRix24 has a bunch of different tools, but the one I want to highlight is its comprehensive task and project management system. This works extremely well both on desktop and mobile devices. With this, you have a full task and project manager. When creating a task, you can assign it to anyone in your team. For a task, you can add a note, a checklist, or even upload files. You can even create documents, spreadsheets, and presentations right in the task as attachments. Then there are the project management side of things. I really appreciate that the projects kind of get their own subcategory. In here, you can lay things out in a list view, a Kanban board, which is my personal favorite, a Gantt board, and it even has a calendar view as well. This way, you can lay out your projects and tasks in a view that is most effective for you to visualize your work. The core of BitRix24 is all about collaboration. You can share files, arrange calls and meetings, and work on ideas in real time with your team. Bitrix 24 has other tools like calendars, which sync with other services like Microsoft, Apple, and Google, so you don't have to move your appointments. This means all of your organization's information can be in one place, and you and your team can stay organized. Bitrix 24 isn't just on the web and desktop, but also has a great mobile app as well. Here you can access all of your tasks and projects, along with shared files, calendars, and other collaboration tools. If you work with a team of people, you really should check out Bitrix 24. I'm going to put some links in the description below so you can learn more and sign up for free. My thanks to Bitrix 24 for sponsoring this video. A big task I've been doing with this MacBook Air is writing. I was sick for the last week and lost my voice, so one of the very few things I could do creatively was write. I do all my writing in Obsidian. I've made a couple of videos about that that I will link to below. Everything from the iPad version carries over, including my theme and plugins. When writing scripts, I just like to have an environment where I can just focus and block out distractions. Now, sometimes I will go to work at a local bagel place, but because I don't like filming in public, we're just gonna stay home today. When I have gone out of the house, one thing I don't worry about is getting a table near an outlet. The MacBook Air's battery life is insanely good. If I start my day with 100% battery life, not only can I make it through my whole workday, but I can make it part of the way into the next workday before I need to charge. This is not something I've ever got with the iPad. In fact, I regularly have to charge my iPad halfway up through my working day. A macOS feature I have been taking advantage of a lot is full screen mode for apps. This hides everything, including other apps, the dock, and even the menu bar. This really helps me focus just on the task in front of me. You can add apps to a split view style multitasking system by dragging and dropping them onto the app that is full screen from spaces in Mission Control. I do this quite a bit with Obsidian and a Safari window when I'm doing research for a script. One of my big complaints about macOS is it always seemed busy and distracting compared to the iPad. Full screen apps really help with that. The keyboard on the MacBook Air is pretty good for a laptop keyboard, though I still prefer my mechanical keyboards when possible. One of my favorite apps that I've been using lately is called Calendar 366. On the Mac, this is just a menu bar app. It shows your upcoming appointments and, if you use Apple Reminders, your current and upcoming tasks. What I like about this is it's just a menu bar, meaning it can appear in any space and even full screen apps. It also has a global keyboard shortcut so you can trigger it. I set up hyperkey C so I can trigger it at any point. So anytime I want to see what I need to do next, I can just hit that combo and it pops up. I can mark task as completed or see what event is coming up next. This has been extremely handy. Despite having lost my voice, unfortunately I've had a ton of video calls lately. So I've been using the app Hand Mirror. This is another menu bar app. When you click on its icon, it activates your webcam and gives you a little preview window. This way you can check your background, lighting, hair, whatever. If you do a lot of video calls, this is a really handy utility. Before, I used to launch the FaceTime app all the time just to get a quick preview. Now, on the MacBook Air, the webcam actually got upgraded to kind of be the equivalent of the new MacBook Pro's webcam. In decent lighting, it looks really good, at least good enough for video calls. Now, one thing I didn't expect this MacBook Air to handle is video editing. I decided to load up an episode of Comfort Zone, which is a 4-video track and a couple of audio bits podcast. Due to the fact that this MacBook Air only has 16 gigs of RAM, I had to close out all the other apps I had open. But once I did, Final Cut was as smooth as butter over warm bread. I edited the whole episode and even did the AI audio processing with Hush right from the MacBook Air. I did play around with one of my YouTube videos on this machine. Due to it only having 512 gigabytes of storage, I couldn't edit right on the internal storage of the machine and had to use an external drive. It's not my favorite way to edit videos. I got smooth playback, but once I started using heavier effects, it did slow down noticeably. Overall, the performance I'm getting out of this slightly spec-bumped MacBook Air is really impressive. The only thing different between this one and the base MacBook Air is it has an extra 2 GPU cores and slightly more storage. My big complaint about the MacBook Air, though, is the display. It's just an LCD display, and it's really looking dated now. Hopefully, the MacBook Pro's mini LED display can slide down the line. Now, my last task on my to-do list for the day is to work on thumbnails for this video. Typically, I use Lightroom and Photoshop for this, both pretty heavy apps. Thanks, Adobe. I started with Lightroom and have a few different presets I've made. Presets are never perfect because every image is different. These get me about 80% of the way there, but I still spend some time tweaking the image. If the image has a device screen in it, I send it over to Photoshop. Typically, taking a photo of a device and getting the screen to be properly exposed is really hard. So for clarity's sake, I go into Photoshop and replace the screen with a screenshot. This isn't an intense Photoshop workflow at all, it's only a few layers, but the MacBook Air handles this perfectly. Before I close everything up for the end of the day, I like to take a couple of minutes to go back and make sure I'm prepped for the next couple of days. I like to go over my calendar and task manager for that. You know, if I'm filming something the next day, do I need to put any devices on the charger so I'm not waiting around for that? Do I need to order any gear or props for a video? Do I have any outstanding important emails I need to deal with? Stuff like this that just taking a couple minutes to deal with it now can give me a huge leg up for the next couple of days. This MacBook Air, I believe, is the perfect example of why you don't always need to buy a maxed out MacBook Pro. This isn't even a maxed out MacBook Air, and it handled most of my workflow perfectly. It really wasn't until I got to the higher end of my workflow that I started to feel the edges of this MacBook Air. Overall, I'm really enjoying working from the Mac again. It's been fun exploring new apps and apps that I haven't checked out in a really long time and apps that have just been updated. Plus system tweaks with either third-party or even first-party settings that would never happen on the iPad. And the battery life. Oh, that battery life is amazing. What I would give to get that kind of battery life, the MacBook Air's level of battery life, on an iPad Pro. I want to hear from you all. Let me know what you think about the new MacBook Air in the comments below. My thanks to BitRix24 for sponsoring this video. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button, subscribe if you haven't already, and have a great day.